have cash, what can I invest in? So you see, that question is most likely to give you a long-winded response and bring you back to where you started from with no answers. Hi guys, my name is Ola and I'm your personal finance fitness blogger. And the reason why I said that is this: how am I supposed to know what you should invest in? How can you just walk up to me and I'll just tell you, okay, buy this, okay, buy that, okay, buy that? The best I can do is actually give you a generic response and give you all the things you already know, the investment options that are available. But how do I know what you should invest in? I can't say. What I mean by that is this: there are many reasons why people invest. I need to know what you're trying to achieve. I need to know what your timelines are. I need to know if you have a lever to actually do this investment that you might be aiming for, right? So those are the kind of things that come that would actually inform that answer. But I find that a lot of people are really not interested in getting that really long answers. They just want you to say, cool, buy this, buy that, buy that. But do you know that that is how MMM and Co. thrive? Yeah, I said it. That is how they thrive. That is how people buy stocks that everybody's buying and end up getting burnt. And see, this, am I saying that you can't ask for what to invest in? No, I'm not saying that. I'm saying that when you're asking that question, you should attach what you're trying to achieve to the question so that it's easier to get the right answer. Right. What do I mean, for example? So four friends have $1 million. One person's rent is due at the end of the year in December. Another person wants to put that money away for future purposes, no particular plan. Another person wants to go to school next year. And then another person is planning for their wedding next month. All four people decide they want to invest that money. Can I give them the same answers as to what to invest? No. But if you just come to me and say, I want to invest, I can tell you, go and buy bonds. They have the highest yields. And bonds might not just be great for the guy that needs his money in a month's time, because he might not be able to get it at that time. Right? But for the guy that is just investing and putting money in bonds, is it? So basically, what am I saying? That you need to define your goals. One reason why people lose money when it comes to investing or feel trapped when they put their money in investments is that they don't realize that that investment doesn't fit them. So it is your goal that will decide whether this investment suits you or not. But of course, if you are going long term, then you are more open. Meaning that if you are just investing for the future, for retirement, then you are more open to all sorts of for different investment options. But the closer the time is to your need for that cash, the less options you have, the less risky you should go. The more firm you are, meaning that if you need money in 3 months' time, why don't you just buy a 90-day treasury bill so that you are sure that you get your money at that time. Now, I'm saying this because the mindset towards investment should move from kalu kalu, gamble, because it's an art, it's a skill, you can be educated in it, right? It is not random. There are fundamentals to this thing. And so we need to start thinking like that so that we can actually preserve our wealth. So the first thing you need to do is to set your own goals. One, once you set that goal, then you can actually ask the right question. I have this amount of money. This is what I'm trying to achieve. What investments can take me to that goal? That is how to do it. You can't ask that question in isolation. You need to be able to guide the conversation so you actually get the right answers. What we also find is that some people come and they're like, okay, I want to put my money in something, but they don't tell you that they need the money in 2 months' time. They don't tell you they need the money in 3 weeks' time. Then you tell them to put their money in an investment that has like a minimum time before you can liquidate. And then they come like, these people have held my money. They're angry and all that. But you don't see that you're trying what you're trying to achieve with that money, right? So while we are also talking about investing, we need to align it with what we're trying to achieve, our goals. We need to have a conversation with ourselves. So this is me telling you to set those goals, telling you to define them. So it might be in your mind, write them down, let it be clear, right? So that when you are posed with investment options, you can somewhat tell this one will suit me or this one won't, because you know where you are going. I trust this was useful. I look forward to hearing from you about this goal setting and questions. If you have any questions about it, feel free to ask. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the notification button. And don't forget that there are two things you can't outsource: your health and your finances. So you have to engage. Your mind needs to be there. Thank you so much for your time. Bye.